Tuesday afternoon flow. I'm Kira. This is Cindy. We'll be speaking today. I know it is our first time flowing together. I've been in here with you guys for some of the other classes assisting, but I'm really excited to be here leading you guys through the flow of today. So we're just going to go ahead and get started. Of course, if you need any props or anything like that, just wave us and we will bring you whatever you need. So we are going to start in Sukta Baddha Konasana, everybody. So that's kind of your reclining butterfly pose. So take whatever posture. We're just going to start here for a few minutes. You can put either a block or a cushion under your knees. And we are going to lay back. And you can take your arms pretty much wherever feels comfortable. They can be out to a T. You can have one hand on your chest and one on your lower abdomen, above your head, practice out, really whatever is most comfortable for you. And we are just going to settle into the space, become fully present on our mat. Everything that is outside of this room is of no concern to us right now. We're going to bring our body and our mind within the four corners of our mat and just get really comfortable here, prepare ourselves for a nice, juicy vinyasa flow. To pay attention to your breath. This should be a super big hip opener, so with every inhale, you can send your breath down into your hips. Let them just relax open a little bit more. If you have your arms teed out to the side, you might be opening your chest and your shoulders as well. So just let the breath flow to any sticky parts and also those hips as we open them up to our relax. Take one more breath all together here. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your nose. And then slowly take your hands to the outside of your knees. Close your knees together like a book. Stay on your back. You can move your props out of the way. And we're just going to hug the knees into the chest and start taking little circles on the back. And slowly we're going to Begin rocking back and forth, just up to a seated position. Beautiful. So here we are going to cross our left leg in front of the right leg. So we're all here on the same side. I am not mirroring you guys. We're doing the opposite. Left leg in front, and we're just really slowly going to start taking our chest in circles. So when we come forward, we're going to arch the back a bit, do a little bit of a cat, and then go back into a cow type back. Switching between arching and doming out the back. slowly. You can keep the tops of your feet down towards the mat to get the blood flowing again to the toes. Then we are going to sit back on the heel. Take your left hand, grab your right knee, and you're going to lightly pull. Stretch out now the front of the foot. So it's a counter stretch to what we were saying before. Should feel really good on your feet. That'll then flex in the other direction. And then switch sides. Take your right foot to your right knee. Gently pull up while you're pressing your toes into the ground to feel that stretch on the top of your foot. Amazing. All right, we are now going to come forward to a tabletop position. Get the wrists warmed up a little bit. So you are going to just start taking circles around, make sure all of your fingertips are pressed into the ground. Slowly move around so you can feel all directions and all parts of your wrists warming up. And take the circles in the other direction. Take one of my favorite wrist stretches. So you're going to take your hand, you're going to take one hand, right hand, and flip it back towards your body so your palm is facing up. And then one at a time, you're going to try to touch each finger to your wrist. It should feel really good on the back of your hand. I do this all the time, and I'm still like so far away, so if you can touch your wrist, more power to you. So just go through and try to take each finger. Position. I'm going to finish up our warm-up with a little bit of cat-cow. So inhale, turn your gaze up, arch your back, and on the exhale, bone your back, take your gaze down. Move with your own breath, inhaling out, exhaling back down. Keep moving through whatever feels good, whatever pace feels good to you. Make sure you're really leading this movement with your pelvis and your spine, not your neck and your gaze. So your neck and your gaze should follow, not lead the move. Really good. If you want, you can take it side to side, take it into circles, whatever feels good for you. I love to do like a little barrel roll, get all parts of my spine, whatever feels good to you. Push back into a quick child's pose. Keep it active, keep your arms engaged. And while we're here, I just want to ask everybody to set a specific intention for the class today. I'm going to share with you guys that my intention for today for this class is to really focus on transitions, which you will see as we start moving through. So that's beyond just focusing on the asana, the poses. It's really focusing on moving from one pose to the next. Obviously, in the rest of our lives, that can also look like, you know, not just focusing on big events, but moving day to day as well. Like, we need to focus and put energy into that as well, and we'll have very filled, wholesome life. So, you can take that, you can lead it, you can set your own intention. We're going to take a big breath here together, in through the nose, out through the mouth. So come with me, inhale, deep in. And breathe it all out. My last reminder for you guys is that child's pose is always here for you if you ever need it once you start to flow. So if you're inclined to take child's pose or shavasana or seated pose, whatever is comfortable for you. But I also want to remind you that growth and change, progress, and all of that generally comes from putting ourselves into a bit of an uncomfortable situation. So, move with me and let's have a little bit of fun. From your child's pose, you are going to take your gaze up to your hands, come forward again into tabletop. Make sure your hands are right below your elbows and your knees are right below your hips. From here, we are going to tuck our toes and immediately come into a hovering table. So we are going to lift our knees about 3 centimeters off the ground and press in between our shoulder blades. So it feels almost like you're doming your back. Engage the core. Hold it here for 5, 4, 3, and without moving your hips or your shoulders, you are going to step first your left leg and then your right leg back into a plank. So our hips are staying low. Beautiful. Amazing. Engage the core. So strong. Warming up for 5, 4, 3, 2, push back into downward dog. Stretch everything out. Really good. Make sure all the fingers are spread wide. Push those shoulders away from your ears as your hips go up towards the sky. A really good cue that somebody told me once about my heels was rather than rotating your toes in and your heels out, is just kind of try to hide your heels from yourself. So if you look back, your heels should just move out ever so slightly so that you cannot see them anymore. Not a super drastic movement, but you're just kind of trying to like hide your heels from your own field of vision. All right, we are going to move back through that plank to a hovering table in the opposite direction. So on your next inhale, I want you to inhale forward to a plank. And we are going to hold it here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. And on your next breath, inhale, bring your left leg in and then your right leg into hovering table without your knees on the ground. Beautiful. Press the leg. Really engage your core, press between your shoulder blades. 5, 4, 3, 2, drop your knees, press back to child's pose. Beautiful. If you want to loosen up your shoulders a little bit, you can take your hands around towards your heels. Let your hips sink between your knees. We are going to go through that one more time. So if your arms are back, put them above at the top of your mat. Lift your gaze to your hands and come back up into tabletop. Make sure that your form is correct. So your hands should be directly below your shoulders, knees below your hips. Tuck your toes under And in 3, 2, 1, we are going to push up into hovering table. Beautiful, so strong. Pull the core in, press out through your shoulder blades. So strong. Okay, this time we are going to start with our right foot. So step your right foot and then your left back into plank without moving your upper body. So good. Just hold it here. And we are going to push back in 3, 2, 1, into downward dog.
Stretch it out. Get a little bit of relaxation between those really powerful moves.
Ruby, and on the next inhale, we are going to shift forward into plank. This is the last one, so bear with me, guys. Hold it here really strong. Tuck that tailbone under. Really engage both the front and back body. 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. Step the right leg in first, followed by the left leg to floating tabletop. Last push, last push, last push. We'll make it a quick one. Hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2. Drop your knees. Push back into child's pose.
Woo, feeling a little bit warm? Nobody?
Good. Let's slow a little bit. So bring our hands back up to the top of your mat. And we are going to push back first into downward dog. From here, come up onto your toes and super slowly walk on your tippy toes. Really slow, really small steps to the front of your mat. Stay on your tippy toes as long as you possibly can. And when you get to the top of your mat, walk your feet out to hip distance. Grab opposite elbows, and we are just going to swing and hang for a little bit, stretching out the back of the legs.
Let your head hang super heavy as our entire spine releases, kind of stays down.
You can shake your head no, nod your head yes, everything all loosened up. Go ahead, release your hands to the ground, toe heel your feet together, and slowly with a bend in your knees, rise to standing.
You get to the top of the shrug, your shoulders down your back. And in Tadasana. And let's just quickly, if you made your own intention or if you're going with me, Tadasana vision, let's call that to mind. Also remember to seal our lips and engage our Ujjayi breathing through our nose. And we are going to go ahead and we are going to go through one sun salutation here together as a group. So come with me. Inhale, hands rise. Exhale, forward.
Inhale, halfway lift to a flat back. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to a high plank. Exhale, low plank, chaturanga, or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, press back to downward dog. Take a couple breaths here through your nose. Inhale, look forward between your hands. Step to the top of your mat. Inhale, flat back, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. And inhale, come with me.
go through. I'm going to move through super, super slowly so that you guys can really focus on the movements and transitions between the asana. Do focus on your breathing, but it won't be quite one breath to one movement because we're going to be moving super slowly, and I don't want you guys to try to be breathing like this. You So come with me. You're going to inhale really strong, slowly. Make sure that your legs, your arms, everything is really, really engaged. We're not just throwing our limbs around here. Next, bring your hands to your heart center and hinge forward. Bring all of your weight into your toes and make sure your core, front and back, are engaged the entire way down. Now when we come here to our forward fold, our legs should still be super engaged, our core should still be on, our hips should be pointing up towards the sky. Come to halfway lift. Again, core is on, kneecaps are engaged, everything is super strong, our weight is still forward in our toes so that everything stays really strong. Exhale, plant your hands. Please do not step back, but slowly step, do not jump back. Slowly step each leg back. So we are in the top of our chaturanga push-up. Our knees, chest, chin. Inhale here. Exhale to a low plank. This is a move in and of itself. We should not be like just a snake coming through it, right? So we're holding it here. Inhale, upward dog. Hold it here. Press into the tops of your feet. Try to lift your knees off the ground if you can. And on the exhale, we are going to lead with our core. Okay? We're going to pull ourselves up using our core. We're going to come into a downward dog. Hopefully slowing it down a little bit, you guys kind of see what I mean about focusing on the transition. We're not just flailing around. Kind of make every part really intentional and really strong. If you don't want to come into a full chaturanga, of course you can just come knees, chest, chin, low cobra, whatever's comfortable for you, but just make sure as you're moving through it, you're really focusing on the part between the asana as well as the pose itself. And I'm also going to ask that for the time being that we don't jump forward or jump back. Really focus on engaging all of your muscles as you step both forward and back. So come with me, look forward, step your right foot forward, followed by your left. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Again, really slowly as you come up. Inhale, bring all of your weight forward in your toes, everything engaged. Come up to a standing position. And exhale, hands to your heart center. Beautiful. All right, you guys get where I'm going with this. We're going to just move again without all the cues, but we are going to move slowly. And you're just going to be very intentional, so come with me. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, plant the hand, step the left, and then the right foot back to a high plank. Inhale here, exhale, low plank. Don't brush it. Inhale, upward dog or cobra. And exhale, pulling from our core back to downward dog. Chill here for a couple of breaths. Beautiful. All right. Inhale, look forward. Step first the left foot, followed by the right. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, come up. Super strong. Exhale, on the leg, mudra, and super center. Beautiful. All right, I'm going to have you guys move through that a couple of times on your own. Take it as slow or as fast as you want, but be really, really intentional about going through all of the motions. So here we go. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Slow at your own pace. Thank you.
real good guy. A real super strong.
Your gaze.
And we're just going to stay here for one moment before we open up to a warrior two. Next one, come to neutral and you're going to meet me in a warrior two, back in the center. From here, we are going to come into a star, so we are going to straighten our arms and our legs. Our toes are going to be pointed out at a 45 degree angle, and we are going to flow between open star, exhale down into goddess. Inhale up into star. Exhale down into goddess. Make sure your tailbone is tucked under. Keep flowing. Inhale up. Exhale down into goddess. Stay straight up. Tailbone tucked under or engage. Move at your own pace. On your next inhale, come up. going to again pivot to a warrior two towards the front of the room. Flip your front palm, reverse warrior, and again curl your hands down to the front of the mat and come through a vinyasa, meet me again in downward dog.
Your left leg to the sky, open up that hip, let the heel drop towards your bum and your knee go towards the ceiling, and really open up that hip.
I like to keep my foot flexed here to really engage that quad into your glute. Really
nice. From here, go ahead, straighten that leg, square the hips. Drop your foot back down. Shift forward to a high plank. This time we're going to plant our right arm under our face. We're going to open to a quick side plank, left arm towards the side. Again, funky transition. Take your gaze down towards your bottom hand. Pull your left knee into your chest, and as best you can, take that left foot and plant it next to your right hand. All right, so we have our left foot down, our right hand planted next to it. We're gonna take our left arm and stretch that up towards the sky. If you want, you can come to your back knee, lower that down to the ground, or you can keep your foot tucked under. Inhale here, on the exhale, we are going to cactus our arm and open and stretch up to the sky. All right, you guys know where we're going. Inhale back straight up. On the exhale, you're going to bring that arm down. On the inhale, it's gonna come up. So our gaze is following our arm as we are coming in a circle. Inhale up. Exhale back down. Okay, perfect. From here, we are going to do the same thing. So lift your left leg, step it forward between your hands. Again, we're coming into pyramid, so for me, I need to step my foot significantly closer to my hands towards the top of my mat. Make sure your hips are squared forward, and we are just going to fold towards our front left knee. Both legs should be straight. There we go. Amazing. Really breathe into that back hamstring. Give it some oxygen, some air, some more room to lengthen. Let it feel really, really good. And again, we are going to take our hands to our hips and slowly, using our legs, we are going to push ourselves. Sorry, I'm rushing to get over here. And then from here, we're going to pivot again to the Buddha side of the room. We're doing another forward fold, so you might want to walk your legs out. It's the most comfortable width for you. From here, we're going to clasp our hands behind our back. If you can leave your palms together, that's ideal. If not, no problem, you can go like this. We're going to inhale, puff up the chest. On the exhale, again, we're going to fold forward, leading with the chest,
and letting our bound arm fall over our head. Again, letting your breath go to all of those tight spaces. Really lengthen them. Inhale, give yourself length. And on the exhale, let yourself go down a little bit deeper. Fold a little bit more. Beautiful. All right, on the inhale, go ahead and come slowly back up to standing. Release your arms, kick them out a little bit. And you're going to come back to warrior two, to the front of the mat. Go ahead and flip that front palm, reverse warrior, and on the exhale, cartwheel down again to the front of the mat. Go through your own vinyasa. Knee again, and down the dog. Here, look towards the top of your mat. Step your left leg forward, followed by your right leg. Inhale, flat back, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold.